all new bottle glass, doesn't it? Now, in the most simple terms, I think Paul's invitation to the church is about gratitude. How might we stand in gratitude, see with gratitude, and hold gratitude constantly in our hearts? Now, Paul, I don't think, could have known anything about all the nifty research that's been done in the last 20 years around gratitude. It tells us, wow, actually, you have there's like an enormous line and no one in front of the gratitude. Because it's true, doesn't it? It's just easier. It's easier to notice what there is to complain, what's not right, what's not working, than to notice all that is and all that's great. But I have to say, when I do notice, man, what joy there is in noticing. But we might ask ourselves, okay, I got it, okay? So, praying without ceasing is noticing God, right? happier in general, you're more content, you are staying more connected to people, you feel less isolated. Okay, so there's all of that, right? But my guess is there's something more. So we're going to do this gratitude journal, which is one of the things that they experimented with, right? They've done studies where they tell somebody to write down things that they're grateful for, another group writes down the things that they find to be hassles to not be, and then one that just writes down things that happen. Doesn't matter what, they have no struggle, just write down things that have happened this week. Time and time again, they find that the gratitude journal folks have made the difference, right? And here's the instructions. Pretty simple. You're going to get a little journal. Sorry, I'm not passed out. You get to choose your own color. Blue, green, black, or red. Okay, blue, green, black, or red. Here it comes. And all you're going to do is this. Every day. Sharpen it, right? Make it a little bit stronger than just writing things down.